Hey guys, Matt Furtow here from Entrack. In this video, we're going to walk through the Rock Toolkit sound pack in Entrack Studio Suite by building a track like the one we can see and hear using the royalty-free loops and instruments available in the Rock Toolkit pack. For those that don't know how to download a sound pack in Entrack, it's simple, and this process applies to iOS, Android and Windows, as well as this example using a Mac. We'll open the loop browser by clicking on the loop browser icon. Inside the loop browser, we'll select add-ons, where we can see all of the available sound packs. We want to search for Rock Toolkit. There it is. Let's click on Rock Toolkit, and we can see that the add-on manager automatically appears and gives us the option to download the pack. So let's click get to download the pack. Once the pack is downloaded, it's ready to use. After downloading the Rock Toolkit, you'll have access to new loops and instruments. Let's start by listening through some of the royalty-free loops. We can import loops by dragging them in the Entrack project or double-clicking. Loops will automatically sync to the project tempo. Let's try this with Rock Straight Beat 1. Let's repeat the loop by dragging on the edge like so, and we'll loop this part by selecting 8 bars and pressing the loop button. This is useful so we can circle round the groove or trying out chords and melodies. So let's add some guitar and bass. Click on the Add Channel button and select Add Blank Instrument Track. From the pop-up window, we'll scroll down and select Guitars and Basses, and then Rock Toolkit. We'll then select Guitar Distorted, and we'll also select Rock Bass. We'll add another new instrument track. We'll go to Guitars and Basses, select Rock Toolkit, and then Rock Bass. We'll make sure to enable the track for recording. My personal favourite sound from Rock Toolkit is to record these two instruments at the same time. It packs a real punch, as we'll hear now. Let's record the guitar and rock bass over the drum beat. And if you don't play keyboard, you can select from the riff loops included in the Rock Toolkit pack. Let's mute what we just recorded in and import guitar riff from the loop browser. So we'll scroll to find guitar riff and click and drag the loop into the timeline. We'll drag on the bottom right of the audio file to repeat the loop. We can also change the pitch of the loop by choosing the musical key from the drop-down menu on the loop. The Rock Toolkit also includes drum kits. To access these, we'll select the Add Channel button and select Add Blank Step Sequencer Track. We'll select the Drums and Percussion category, then Rock Toolkit Kits and Rock Solid. This will take us to the step sequencer. Let's build a drum groove that complements our drum loop. We want to create a bit of space and a drum tom bass pattern like this. Let's add back in the previous drum loop to hear the grooves together. We'll repeat the loop and select the first 8 bars of the project, looping them by selecting the loop button. We'll go back to the MIDI riff that we played in and repeat it twice more so we have the main hook to our track. Let's also loop the rock straight beat one loop twice more to complete the first 16 bar section of this track. What we need now is to add a breakdown, otherwise this track will start to sound too repetitive. For the breakdown, we'll use another drum pattern. We'll try Rock Tribal Beat 1, which is a great contrast to our original drum pattern. Let's click and drag the loop into the project. We'll also record four ascending notes on the distorted guitar and rock bass instruments to build some track tension. If you don't have a MIDI keyboard, you can also play in notes via the screen keyboard, like so. Let's raise the intensity at the end of this new section by adding the Rock Tribal Beat 2 loop. Let's click and drag the loop into the project. We'll repeat the four ascending notes to create more tension. Let's really crank up the tension for the last few bars of the breakdown before returning to the original riff. We'll add guitar chord and guitar tension solo to the project and change the loop keys to match the song. We'll import guitar tension solo into the project and we'll raise the pitch from the original A5 to E6. Let's take a listen. Sounds good, but the last part sounds a bit out of tune, so we'll shorten the loop, repeat it, change the first half to E5, one octave lower. So let's take a listen to that. Much better. To return to the original riff, we'll copy and paste our first section into the project after the new breakdown section. We'll copy the first 16 bars and paste them at bar 25 after our new section. Let's listen to the transition between these two sections. This full track is included in the project section of N-Track Studio with all parts, MIDI and effects so you guys can use it, change it, or see some of the techniques used to help your own music making. You can locate this track as well as others from the loop browser like this. Click on the loop browser icon to open the loop browser, select Beats, Projects, and then the track that you want to open. Click on the track once to hear a preview of the track and double click to open the track project. It's important to note that Rock Toolkit is a premium sound bank. It's included when you subscribe to N-Track Studio Suite Edition on mobile or buy the Suite Edition for Windows or Mac. The Suite Edition includes every sound pack available in N-Track, more detail in the links above and in the description below this video. If we open the track mixer, you'll see that we've used effects on the track parts like amps, reverbs and tremolos to enhance the sound of the project. All of these plugins can be located and used within N-Track Studio. If you want to learn more about using these plugins, check out one of our videos, like our guitar amp tutorial video, or how to mix vocals in N-Track Studio, which discusses N-Track plugins in detail. Also, please let us know in the comments additional sample packs and instruments you'd like us to add in N-Track, and don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe. Until next time, have fun making music in N-Track. Cheers.